We're going to sing one more song. And while we sing this song, if there's someone here and you want to come and you want to pray, that's what these altars here for.
Amen.
That song, that's what the altar is for.
Amen.
See, I came up in the Church of God. I came up in this Pentecostal thing. You know, I'm not trying to make somebody come and be praying. But if you want prayer, I'm willing to pray for you, and I'm willing to see God take care of you. See, I'm ready to challenge you. If you need God, and if you need God to heal you, if you need God to touch you, I'm willing to challenge you. I'll pray for you now. I believe right now, before you leave here, that God will heal you, just like He did Phyllis, just like He did Sister on the back. We got several people in this church that's already been healed. They got it on x-rays. They got proof from the doctor that they had it, and now they don't. Hallelujah. They got proof that they were sad and they needed surgery, but they don't need it now because God healed them. Let me tell you something. God is able to answer your prayer.
Oh, yes. Amen.
Don't sit there and listen to the enemy. You know what you're saying? I guess I'll just hold on. I guess I'll just hold on to my sickness. I love my sickness so much I'll just hold on. I love my sin so much I just don't even call in God's name. See, we cannot be in that way of receiving the inheritance of the Lord. The only way we're going to get the inheritance of the Lord is when we respond to God. I'm going to do one more thing before we close today. Who wouldn't bow your head and close your eyes? I'm going to ask you a question. I want you to be truthful in your heart. And I promise you I'm not going to call you out. I promise you I'm not going to try to do that, you know, that Pentecostal thing that they do. I'm not going to try to knock you out. I'm not going to try to do all that. But I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to pray for you. That don't mean I'm going to call you up here and pray, but I'm going to pray for you. If you're in this place this morning and you want a closer relationship with the Lord, I just want to ask you to raise your hand. Thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Thank you, 7. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Anybody else? Anybody else? Thank you. Eight people need a touch, a closer relationship with God. Anybody in here that's you're dealing with an infirmity in your body and you need God to touch you? I want thank you. Thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wow. Praise the Lord. Anybody in here you just feel like you're battling oppression? Anybody in here? Oh, hallelujah. 1, 2, 3. Oppression. Wow. God, right on top. Listen, we're going to pray right now. We're going to have an altar call right where we're at. If that makes you feel comfortable, I want to do that for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you, Lord, to touch those people and give them an encounter that needs a closer relationship with you.
Yes, God.
I pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, that you will loosen all of the bands of pain and all of the bands of wickedness, oh God, and everything, God, that may be holding them back from that relationship with you. Lord, show them that all they got to do is trust in you. Father, I pray, God, for them that has an infirmity in their body. And Lord, I pray that you will take it out of this field, that you will take it out of your people. That God, that you will touch your people from the top of their head to the bottom of their feet. And God, that we will have another powerful service like the Azusa Street Revival. Lord, you remember in the Azusa Street Revival, we had paupers and we had doctors, we had lawyers, we had all kinds of people that came to the Azusa Street Revival. And Lord, you were touching them and they were blessing them in to feel your mighty touch. And I pray for Lord for the same mighty touch that will approach this congregation this morning. Oh God, and touch them from the top of their head to the bottom of their feet. And I say, infirmity, be gone. He said, I've been